In this lecture, we are going to discuss about Hamiltonian cycle. Hamiltonian cycle means here, if you are having a graph, in that graph, you have to start with one vertex and you have to traverse each vertex only once and return back to the original node, origin node. Right? So here, for example, in that graph, we are having four vertices and edges. Now, here you have to start with node 1. The node 1, then we are having edge 2, 3, 4, and then 1. So this is one Hamiltonian cycle. Or otherwise, we can have that 1, 4, 3, 2, 1. So this is another Hamiltonian cycle. So we are having two Hamiltonian cycles in that particular graph. Now, here for whatever graph it may be, then if you are Hamiltonian cycle is available, then it will give that result. Here is some graph. Cannot have a Hamiltonian cycle. If you are having an articulation point within that graph, then there is no possibility. If you are having articulation point here, you are moving, you are crossing that articulation point, then you have to return back to articulation point. So then once again you are visiting that node. This is not the case in the Hamiltonian cycle. So in that Hamiltonian cycle, if you are starting from one node, you have to move, you have to reach all vertices only once and return back to that origin node. So this is a Hamiltonian cycle. Now you consider we are having a graph. In that graph, first you find out the adjacency matrix so that you are representing that graph in the adjacency matrix. So using adjacency matrix, now how we are going to find out the Hamiltonian cycle? That is we are going to see, right? Now how we are finding now? So you have to start with that node 1, then its adjacent nodes are 2 and 4. So here from that 1 we can reach either 2 or 4. So you have to start with that node 1. So in the ascending order you are moving to node 2. Then from the node 2, then the not yet visited node you have to. So in the node 2 the adjacent nodes are 1 and 3. So 1 and 3, here 1 is already visited. So you have to go for that node 3. Then from that node 3, the adjacent nodes, so 2 and 4, so 2 is already visited, so you have to go for 4. Then you are completing the all node, then you have to find out whether a path is available from 4 to the origin node 1. If it is available, then this is one cycle. Then you have to find out all possible cycle. So what actually we have to do is here 4. So from that 4, you have to return back. And from here 3, so is there any other alternate path for that one? Here there is no alternate path. Then from 2, you have to go for any other alternate path. Here no. Then from 1, any other alternate path means here we are moving to 2. Now we can move to next adjacent node 4. So 1 to 4 and 4 to 3 and 3 to 2. 2 to 1. This is another cycle. Now you see this one here in that particular tree, right? Tree model. So you are having a backtracking. So we can represent by entity model. So if you are considering that all space, then we are having a big tree. But here we are going to consider only the solution nodes, right? Now you see this one solution branches. Now you see this one, you have to start with node 1. Node 1, next adjacent node is 2. Then from this 2, the adjacent node is 3. From the 3, the adjacent node is not yet visited is 4. Then from that 4, that 4 to, then we can go for 1. So we are having that edge. So this is the path. 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, and 4 to 1. So this is the path, one result. Then another one, here we are having, so you have to find out the path, then you have to return back to 2. Then from that 1, then another adjacent node is 4. So you have to go for 4. For that 4, the adjacent node is 3. Then for that 3, we have to go for 1 and for 2. So here, this is another alternate path. Alternate path. So here, first you have to consider all nodes are not yet visited, so all are 0. Then you have to consider for first node is 1. Then you have to start with the second node and third node and fourth node, and you have to, so you are visiting all node. Now here, from here to, then you have to consider all are not yet visited. So from 1, then you can visit 4. Then from that 4, we can visit 3. From that 3, we can visit 2. From that 2, we are having a path to origin. So we are having another alternate Hamiltonian cycle. Now we are going to see the algorithm. Here, in that algorithm here, this is actually, we are having backtracking. So we are having that one regressive procedure call. Now you see this one Hamiltonian cycle. In that Hamiltonian cycle, you have to start with the Hamiltonian one, right? First you have to assign the node 1 is 1. So the origin is 1. So origin is 1 means origin is visited. Origin 1 is visited. Next we have to go for the next node. So you have to start with the Hamiltonian of second node. So second node. So next node is which node? Second node is which node you have to find out, right? Next value of 2, right? So of 2 means next value. Next value means next node you are going to mine. So that one here, next value. So the next value function is we are having some bounding, right? So here we are going to have that one node is actually, we can have that node 1, 2, 3, 4, only 4. So here we are using that mod 5. Mod 5 means, so we can have that one 1, 2, 3, 4. So if you are adding further, then it will go for 0, right? So with this 0 is actually, you find out that we are completing that all node. Now you see this one, we are starting with the next value of 2. Now 2, already that x2 is not yet visited, so x2 is 0. Now we are having the x2 0 plus 1, 1, mod 5 is 1, so x2 of 1. X2 of 1, then what will happen here? X2 of 2 is 1. Initially, x2 of 2 is 1. Here, x2 equal to 0, no. Right, now we have to consider that one. So x minus 1 is 1, so this is also 1. So 1 comma 1 not equal to 0, so 1 comma 1 is 0. 1 comma 1 is 0, so this is not the case, right? Then it will come to here. Next increment, x2 equal to x2 plus 1. So x2 is 1, 1 plus 1, 2. Mod 5, so 2. We are getting now result 2. So second to node 2. Now this is not equal to 0. So now 1, 1, 2. So for the 1, 2, we are having a path. Then it will enter into here, right? So here, what actually we have to do is whether already visited node, right? If now j equal to 1, 1 x of 1 is equal to x of 2. So x of 1 is 1, x of 2 equal to 2. So this condition is not satisfied. If it is satisfied, it will play. What do you mean by that one is that already visited node. If it is already visited node, we are having that equal of the previous nodes. So here, this is for finding already visited node, right? So the node should be not yet visited only, we have to consider. So for that, we are having, this is the case, right? Now, here, if you are having, you are reaching that node, that one, then j equal to k. So that for loop is complete. So we are having j equal to k. Now here we have to consider, now we are having two possibility, right? K is less than n or k equal to n. So here k is less than n, then what you have to do is return. Or otherwise, k equal to n means, then what it mean as actually we are going to have last node. So for that last node, we have to have a path to the origin node. So for that, we are checking now this condition also. So if k equal to n, and also you have to be satisfied this one. So what do you mean by that one? As if it is last node, then last node to the origin node, you should have a path. Then only it will return. Here, if it is not there, then we have to continue that one. So we have to continue that one. If you are reaching that 4 and 5, now we are getting now the result. If 4 node, you complete all 4 node, then you are having that 4 plus 1, 5. 5 mod 5 is 0. Now that 0 is going to have return. So return to here. Now in that return, we are having a possibility is xk is 0, or k equal to n, or k less than n, right? Now we are having three possible result of the next value of k. So x of k is 0, then return. Here otherwise, k value is equal to n means we are finding one cycle. So then it will print. Otherwise, then we are having in the middle of the node, then we have to go for next adjacent node. Here, next node you want to find out. So Hamiltonian of k, now we are calling that one Hamiltonian of k plus 1. So this is, we are starting with that one, Hamiltonian of 2 is you are going to start, then Hamiltonian of 3, Hamiltonian of 4, then after that we are having that 4 to 1 is we are this condition. So 4 to 1 is available, so this is one path. Now it will return to here, k equal to n, then it will print that path. Next, then it will continue now. So here there is no further branch. Then Hamiltonian is returning back, then it will reach to here. Now from here, once again we are start with now, that node is here. Now you have to continue that one of here, 1 to 4. So next adjacent node you have to consider. Next adjacent node you have to consider means then you have to consider that instead of that 2, you have to consider 4. Then you have to continue now. Then we are having another alternate Hamiltonian path. That's all, right? So this flowchart is the explanation of the corresponding, yes, right? Now, if you consider all possible cases, right? Now we are having that one as here, if you consider in the, we are having that possibility is 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, and 4 to 1. Then 1 to 2, 2 to 4, 4 to 3. So here all permutation we are having now. In that permutation, here we are getting now the result, this one as result, and this one as result. The all others are, we don't have that particular corresponding path. So this is two cases, right? Now, we are having the complexity of this one as n power n. So here if you are having 4 node, 4 power 4 is actually the. So here we are having 3 factorial is here approximately n power n. This flowchart is directly having the same concept of algorithm. And also we are having program. So in that program, whatever that in that algorithm directly we are implementing. So here we are having the corresponding program. You go through that program until we are having that result. Now you see this in the result is here 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, and then 4 to 1. Similarly, 1 to 4, 4 to 3, 3 to 2, 2 to 1. So we are having two paths. So whatever graph it may be, then you have to change the number of nodes, and then here you have to change the number of nodes, and also we have to give the corresponding adjacent matrix. Then we are getting now the result of all possible Hamiltonian cycle. If there is no Hamiltonian cycle, it won't give the result. That's all.